Good morning, dear friends. I am Reginium Linus. Today I am going to explain this various configuration of electrical vehicle. So first let me share my presentation so that we can understand what are all the content I am going to explain today. I hope you can see my screen. Yeah, I can see my screen. So today's topic is configuration in electrical vehicle. In the last couple of class, we have learned importance, history and development of electrical vehicle, simulation of buck and boost converter for electrical vehicle applications. Then understood concept of regenerative braking and hybrid electric vehicle, then general block diagram of electric vehicle. So in this lecture, I am going to explain the different configuration. First, let me see that battery electric vehicle, longitudinal front wheel drive. So this is called as converted electric vehicle. So what is converted electric vehicle means? Normally we have IC engine based electric vehicle, IC engine based vehicle. We will replace this IC engine with this electric vehicle, with that motor, that is called as converted electric vehicle. So in this case, we have replaced instead of IC engine motor. Then as usual, as like normal conventional vehicle, clutches will be there. Then gearbox will be there, manual gearbox. Then it will be connected to the transmission, that through the axle we will give the power to that vehicle. So the power to this wheel. So in this case, we are replacing IC engine with small rated motor. Whatever the power rating of the IC engine, we have to use same power rating for this motor. That is a one thing. Then second one, remaining all are same as whatever we have already in this conventional electrical vehicles. So that this gearbox, it will help the motor for variable speed applications. So what happened? This motor just has to run for high speed and high torque always. So gear will control that, manually we will control the speed of the motor, so speed of the vehicle, so that control of motor is not much complex. So we can say this configuration is simple. So normally this configuration will be used for three wheeler and low power cars. Next, let me explain about that longitudinal front configuration with fixed gearing and no clutch. In the previous cases, people have used bulky components, clutch and gearbox. Then researchers have started, why can't we avoid this clutch and gearbox? In order to avoid the clutch, initially people have fixed gearbox is the fixed ratio and the clutch they have removed. That vehicle we will call it as with fixed gearing and no clutch. For that, motor will be there, there is no space of clutch. Then we will give the fixed gearing, then transmissions will be there, axle and motor. So this is the, so that what happened when compared with the previous configuration, weight of this vehicle will be reduced, cost will be also reduced. The reason is clutch, no need of clutch, and manual gearing will be reduced. So this is, so space will be more when compared with the previous vehicle. So that bulk system, clutch and variable system is reduced. We have fixed the gear ratio of 10:1. Motor should be properly controlled. What is the main problem here is, previous cases, vehicle speed can be controlled by variable gear system. But in this case, gear system is constant. So we have to use some sort of complex control of motor so that motor will be motor efficient, so that what happened, motor will be has to be controlled in various speed applications. Accordingly, motor should be efficient high enough in all operating region. It should be high enough in all operating region. Then it should be have a high starting torque and high load torque. So this is the difference in between previous one and current, that with the fixed gearing and no clutch vehicle. So motor control system should be complicated, will be complicated when compared with the previous configuration. Then before going to the next configuration, I would like to explain what is meant by differentials in vehicle. When we will ride the vehicle in this turnings, what happen in the, that we can have that four wheels. Outer wheels are called as outer arc wheel, inner wheels are called as inner arc wheel. So when we see as a center, that from the center to inner arc wheel, the radius is very less when compared with that outer arc wheel, radius is more. So in this case, R2 is greater less than R1, or otherwise R1 greater than R2. So the shaft speed is constant, right? For particular speed, shaft speed is constant. So when we turn the vehicle, what happens? Outer side arc wheel should be faster than inner side arc. Otherwise, we can call inner side arc wheel should be lower than outer side arc, so that this two wheel speed has to be compensated with that shaft speed of this vehicle. So that what happened, driver can ride the car very smoothly. That's why we can say outside side wheel move faster than the inside wheel. Average speed should be constant. Accordingly, we are average should be the same. Accordingly, we have to adjust outer side and inner side. Who will do this type of role? The differential will do this type of role. So that what happened, in this case, when we use single motor system in electrical vehicle also, we need differential. At the same time, when we use dual motor system, separate vehicles or separate motors, if we connected in each wheels, we no need of differential. At the same time, coordination control is needed to coordinate the speed control between that outer side motor and inner side motor. So this is the call it as differential. So I will explain this term is as differential in the next configuration. So you should understand that is what I have explained. Then in this case, detailed block diagram of, in this case, what happened with the transverse front wheel drive, that happened in previous cases, there is a space is what space is there for motor and fixed gearing and all. So in this third configuration, what we are going to do with the transverse front wheel, everything is inbuilt in between the two wheels, fixed gearing, motor and differential, then that is integrated together, then connected to axle. So what happened, gear is fixed, here also motor control is complicated. The reason is motor has to do the control of front wheel as well as driver wheel, and as per the instruction of differential, motor has to be speed should be adjusted. So this, that is the main so that motor is control system is so much complicated. So in this configuration, avoided transmission system, all components are combined together, integrated together. So when compared with previous two configuration, rate is less, compact in size, weight also reduced. It adopted in all electric models in electrical vehicle use. It is used in Tesla vehicles also. So this is the third configuration. Then fourth configuration, where what we will do, as I told you, no need of this differential also. So if we no need of differential, what we have to do, we have to use separate motor with fixed gearing in this two tires separately. So planetary gear system will be used for controlling this motor, first motor. Then coordination control is also needed for coordination control is also needed for doing the duty of differentials. So used in dual motor system, simple and less bulky when compared with previous configuration, differential actions carried out by mutual control and coordination control, eliminate driving axle totally, then fixed gearing system required, planetary gearing system, advanced gearing system is needed in order to control the speed of the motor in all aspects. So this is called as fourth configuration. We will call it as with in wheel motor drive. Then next configuration we can have with outer rotor motor drive. So what will happen? Outer rotor will be in outside, a stator will be in inside. Normal cases we can use configuration of ceiling fan. Outer side is the rotor, inner side is the stator. So here they have avoided that gear system also. So in this case, the motor system in this configuration, motor same speed is same as speed of the vehicle. So simple and less bulky compared to the previous. So here also using dual motor system, differential action is controlled by using mutual control, eliminated driving axle totally, speed of control is already told you, speed of motor control is same as the speed of the wheel. Therefore in this cases we have to use the motor with low speed. Then that is why we will call it as outer. If possible, it will be good if you use the motor, rotor, outer motor as like the configuration of ceiling fan. So then let me explain about that cost, different parameters in single motor and multi-motor system. Cost is low in single motor, multi-motor we need two motor. That is why cost is high, size is lumped one. What happens, single motor system, all the things will be lumped together, but in this multi-motor system the sizes are distributed in separately for one wheel and separate for another wheel. Weight also lumped in one particular place, here also weight is distributed. Then motor rating, high power needed for single motor system, but multi-motor system we can have low power. We are sharing the power by using two motors. The efficiency is low in single motor, multi-motor efficiency is high. Then in the single motor, differential is mechanical. In this multi-motor, differential is electronics. What is mean by electronics? Coordination control, mutual control, everything by done by the electronics. Then controllability, low in the single motor, multiple motor, controllability is more. Then reliability is high, and in single motor, this multi-motor reliability is high if the fault tolerant control is implemented. So these are all the main difference between single motor and double motor system. So then based on the battery, we are explaining different configuration. First configuration is battery will be there, one power converter will be there, then in between another one battery, then power converter 2 is connected to the motor. So this is called, these two are connected together. So in this case, power converter 1, which will control the power flow between battery 1 and battery 2. So in this case, possible of decoupling high speed. What happen? One battery 1 will take care of high energy, specific energy, and battery 2 will take care of high specific power. Like that equally we can share this power sharing, battery 1 and battery 2. So usually this battery one is non-rechargeable battery. So it will be good, this battery 2 will be separate battery bank. This battery 1 and battery 2 normal cases in this configuration not rechargeable battery. So battery, separated battery bank is needed for regenerative braking. Then second configuration, instead of battery 1, we will connect fuel cell. So in this fuel cell, what will happen? Then here one battery will be there. Fuel, as we know, fuel cell is not a storage device. So that fuel cell energy generating device, normally it is a generating device. This configuration is called as with fuel cell and battery hybrid. Need always battery to store the energy from regenerate. Already we already know whenever the regenerative action is happened, this battery will store the energy through the regenerative break. I would like to bring to your kind notice that already I have explained what is mean by regenerative break. Then next one, ultra capacitor and ultra flywheel battery hybrid. In this cases, instead of fuel cell, we are connecting ultra capacitor and ultra flywheel and ultra flywheel, then battery, then power converter. So in this case, what happened? Power converter one should be a boost converter. The reason is output voltage of ultra capacitor, ultra flywheel will be very less. So we need to boost the voltage in order to, it is needed for drive the motor. That is why we have, it should be a boost converter. So also this ultra capacitor and ultra flywheel power converter should be bidirectional. That means this flywheel will also, ultra speed, it will store the energy also. It can be bidirectional. Then power converter one should be a bidirectional to recharge the battery through the regenerative break. That's what I want to say. Bidirectional. In the previous cases, in this previous configuration, see, power converter no need to be a bidirectional. Reason is fuel cell is not a rechargeable device. But in this case, it should be a bidirectional so that energy will be transferred to the whenever the regenerative braking happens. Energy will be transferred to the ultra capacitor. So with this, I would like to conclude the configuration of electrical vehicle. We can meet with another one topic in this next lecture. I hope you can understand whatever I am explaining to in this lecture through this various configuration. With this another topic, we will meet you soon in the next lecture. Wish you all the best.